Hey, now here's something different. Now see, I think I've fallen into a trap of typecasting my content, like all mecha and cute girl anime. So here's a romance. Midnight Secretary, written by Tomu Omi between a vague time in September 2006 to a vague time in June 2009. This series is a Jose romance manga that lacks an anime adaptation, for obvious reasons. The series is essentially a budding romance between the secretary Kaya Satosuka and her boss Kyohei Toma. Kaya essentially gets blackmailed into being Kyohei's secretary because he threatens to have her mother fired if Kaya leaves, since she's apparently the best secretary ever. And she found out he is a vampire. Also, she holds her secretarial duties so high that she offers her blood to him, and that involves sex. Lots of sex. See, ecstasy makes blood better, apparently. Eventually, though, these two fall in love and actually form a pretty cute relationship. Okay, synopsis done. So let's go into more detail here between these two main protagonists. Kaya is a very dedicated and talented secretary. She also tries to hide her baby face. I know the struggle. And because of that, she's afraid people won't take her seriously. Most of the plot, she's struggling with her feelings for her boss, on top of the fact that he puts up this front of just using her. Speaking of Kyohei, he is infamous among other vampires due to his family history that I won't spoil, but because of that, his love for Kaya is very difficult for him because both his life experience and fear of making the supposed mistake of his parents made affects it. Over the course of the series, he develops to be a cute and stalwart partner for Kaya. My biggest problem with this series is a problem I have with many manga and anime like it. There is a vampire clan, and of course, their drama and customs create problems for this couple, but here's why I don't like. I think the dilemma of the human and vampire falling in love should be enough of a drama and conflict. Like Kyohei needing to feed, but here's the problem, that can't be satiated with a single person. I feel like they resolved that plot point way too quickly and focused way too much on this vampire clan. Also, the art can be iffy at times. Necks are a bit weird, but ultimately it gets the blushes done correctly, and that's what's important. Another issue someone would have a problem with is all the sex. Like, there's tons of it. I know some people may be turned off because of that, on top of obviously this is a series marketed to women, and my audience here is mostly men. But what honestly drew me in was I found both protagonists attractive, so it was an overall easy read for me. Even if my face did turn red more than once. I can understand, though, a vampire romance has a negative stigma, and I'm not saying this series is really deep either. I mostly read it for the attractive characters and their owner and property relationship dynamic. Cause yes, apparently I'm one of those weirdos. So if you want a deep romance with tons of conflict, I'd recommend you stay far away. But if you feel like a short and trashy read and are into this, then this manga comes highly recommended. Now, this series is published in English by Viz Media, so it isn't as expensive as other manga. $9.99 sticker price. So if you got a hole burning in your pocket for something vaguely fetishistic, at least it won't come too expensive.